Hello students, myself Amardeep Jadhav, assistant professor in chemistry working at Lord Pushpadevi Patil Arts and Science College, Risar. Today's topic of our lecture is aromatic hydrocarbons. It is BSc first years unit 4. So in introduction, aroma means fragrance, that is pleasant smell. So aromatic compounds are those compounds which have pleasant smell, and the parent aromatic compound is benzene. Aromatic compounds are those compounds which contains more than one or more benzene ring. So benzene ring is the basic unit of aromatic compounds. To this benzene ring, another benzene ring is attached, or that benzene ring can be having a substituent at different places. So those compounds which are having substitution at benzene ring, or one or more benzene ring attached to one another, are comes under the class aromatic compounds. These compounds are also known as arenes. These are some examples of the aromatic compounds. The basic parent unit of aromatic compound, that is benzene. When two benzene ring gets attached to each other, new aromatic compound is formed, and that is naphthalene. When three aromatic rings are attached to one another, that is three benzene rings are attached to one another, such a compound are called as anthracene. When there is a methyl substitution at the benzene ring, this compound is called as toluene. Then if you are having two benzene ring attached to one another and one benzene ring is attached to the benzene ring, other one of the benzene ring at the ortho and the meta position, then such a compound are called as phenanthracene. Now what is aromaticity? According to highly accepted theory, aromatic compounds are those compounds which possess the given characteristics. Okay, so what are the characteristics? It must be cyclic, and it must have to be a planar structure. Then and then only aromaticity can be obeyed by the structure. It must have complete conjugated structure. Complete conjugated structure means what? There should be alternate and double bond in the cyclic compound. Then third character, it has high resolution energy. So high resolution energy means what? More the number of resonating structure, that is resonance structure, higher will be the resonance energy. So compounds must have higher resonance energy. Then fourth character is, it must follow Hockel's rule. What is Hockel's rule? Hockel's rule is that when a compound is said to be aromatic, it should have 4n plus 2 pi electrons in it, where n is the any integer. Suppose you are taking n as a 0, 4 into 0 is 4 plus 2, 6. So if compound having 6 electron, it is an, my calculation was mistake. 4 into 0 was 0 plus 2 was 2 pi electrons. So 2 pi electrons having compound, it obeys Hockel's rule. If n equals to 1, then 4 into 1, 4 plus 2, 6. Then 6 electron having conjugate planar cyclic structure comes under the class aromatic compounds. Okay. And this is nothing but the aromaticity. Now, what is the speciality of aromatic compounds? It preferably undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction rather than addition reaction. So, aromatic compound didn't undergo addition reaction, but rather it prefers to undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. Now, these are the examples of aromatic compounds. First one is cyclopropanyl cation. How many electrons it has? The double bonds having 2 electrons. That's it. And if this double bond shifts over here in between this, then this positive charge comes over to this point. Again, if the double bond from this point shifts to this bond, then the positive charge from this center goes to this center. And this is how the resonating structures will occur. And higher the resonating structure, higher will be the resonance energy. Now in benzene, alternating double bonds are there. So 3 double bonds and 6 sigma bonds. Okay, alternate 3 double bonds. So each bond having 2 electrons, so 3 into 2, 6 pi electrons. So it obeys Hockel's rules as well, and it has high resonance energy as well because of its high resonating structures. It is planar and it is cyclic, right? Then next is naphthalene. Naphthalene having how many electrons? There are 5 double bonds, so 5 into 2, 10 pi electrons. Will it be following the Hockel's rule? Yes, 4 into 2 is 8 plus 2, 10. So 10 electrons are there, so it is following the Hockel's rule as well. Okay, as it is, it will have more resonance structure, so higher will be the resonance energy in it. It is planar and it is cyclic, and these double bonds are in conjugation to one another. So these are the examples of the aromatic compounds, and this is how aromaticity works. Another examples of the aromaticity are cyclopentadienyl anion. Okay, here is negative charge. This negative charge corresponds to two electrons. So two electrons plus two electrons from this bond and two electrons from this bond, total it gets 6. So it follows the Hückel's rule. Plus this charge can shift from one carbon to another carbon, and the compound will show higher resonating structure and delocalization of the electron. This is a planar because whenever the charge is there on the carbon, that carbon shouldn't be go above or below the plane. Okay, if it is above or below the plane, then their charge won't get generated over that center. So whenever charge is there, it should be in a planar form, then and then only charge will be forming on the compound. So it is planar as well and it is cyclic as well. In next example, cyclopentadienyl anion, there are 8 electrons, 2 of this negative charge, then 6 of these double bonds, and all these are in conjugation. This anion, this negative charge can be treated as a 2 electrons, and they can move like this, and there is a conjugation in it. And as we have said that negative charge will be generated on the planar carbon only, so it is having planar structure and it is cyclic as well, and it follows Hückel's rule as well. So these are two also again the examples of the aromatic compounds. Then what is anti-aromaticity? According to IUPAC criteria, anti-aromatic compounds should follow the following 4 points. Okay, so what are these following 4 points or the characteristics? Molecule must be cyclic. Okay, to molecule to become an anti-aromatic, it should have a cyclic structure. Molecule must not be planar. This is the most important thing. Though the molecule is cyclic, it should not be planar. Okay, the next characteristic is molecule must have conjugated electron system. Okay, like in the aromaticity, here also conjugated electron system must have to be there in the aromatic anti-aromatic compounds as well. Okay, and molecule must have 4n electrons. Okay, 4n electrons, where n is any integer, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 into 1 equals to 4, 4 into 0 equals to 0. So all these type of compounds here, if these four characteristics are following, then that compound should be anti-aromatic. Okay, just 2 points were different here. One, the compound must not be planar. In an aromatic compound, it should be planar, and here it follows 4n pi electrons. There in aromatic compounds, it is 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, pi electron energy of aromatic compounds is higher than that of the its chain analog. This is the note point of this anti-aromatic compounds, where pi electron energy of anti-aromatic compound is higher than that of its chain analog. So these compounds are very unstable, and so because of their instability, they react very fast. Okay, anti-aromatic compounds react very fast, whereas aromatic compounds are stable. Okay, then examples of the anti-aromatic compounds: cyclopropanyl anion, it is not planar and the negative charge is there, and then as the negative charge is there, these two electrons move another, but they are having 4 pi electrons, so 4 pi electrons. In cyclobutadiene, there are 2 double bonds, so 4n electrons, then pi electrons. Then in cyclopentadienyl cation, 2 plus 2, 4 pi electrons. Okay, and in cyclopentadienyl anion, 8 electrons, 2, 4, 5, 6, and 8. So 8 electrons, 4 into 2, 8 electrons, 8 pi electrons, right? So these are the examples of the anti-aromatic compounds. Then non-aromatic system. What are non-aromatic compounds? The compounds which neither aromatic nor anti-aromatic but are cyclic and having conjugated double bonds are called as non-aromatic compounds. So here we are having two examples. With these examples, we are going to understand how non-aromatic system we have to find out. Okay, cyclooctatetraene. Okay, cyclic, octa means 5, 8 carbons, and tetraenes means four double bonds are there. So cyclooctatetraene. Tetraene is a cyclic compound with conjugated double bonds. It is having conjugated double bonds, but it does not follow Hückel's rule. Okay, it is not following Hückel's rule, and Hückel's rule is the property or the characteristics which must be followed for a compound to become an aromatic compound. But here Hückel's rule is not followed. 4n electrons are there, 4 into 2, 8 electrons are there, but not 4 into n plus 2. No, that rule is not following. So Hückel's rules are not following. But here it is having 4n electrons, so it is the rule of anti-aromatic. But even though it is anti-aromatic, it is not in a plane. Okay, it is not in a single plane. The compound is non-planar, so it is a non-aromatic compound. Okay, this is how the structure of the octatetraene, cyclooctatetraene, is written. But this is similar to this trine triple bond, means this is similar to this type. Okay, even though we write this, but its actual geometry is like this tub shape. So it is non-planar. For if it is planar and it have pi electrons, then it will be comes under the class anti-aromatics or aromatics. But here those 3-4 conditions are not observed, so the compound comes under the class non-aromatic system. Now second example is cyclodecapentene. Okay, cyclodecapentene, it is a cyclic compound with conjugated double bonds with 10 pi electrons. Okay, so follows Hückel's rule. Here it follows Hückel's rule, that is 4n plus 2 pi electron system is there, but it is not planar because the hydrogens, like this in the structure it is shown, the hydrogens are coming above the plane, one is coming above the plane and one is going below the plane. So this is not an aromatic compound because this is compound is not planar. Now nomenclature of benzene derivatives nomenclature can be given in three types: monosubstituted, where one of the carbon is substituted with some other group. Okay, or hydrogen of the aromatic ring is substituted by other group. Here one chlorine is there, so chlorobenzene. Here nitro is there, so nitrobenzene. Here C2H5 group is there, so ethylbenzene. So this is how the monosubstituted benzenes are there. Then disubstitution, here in the benzene ring two hydrogen atoms are replaced by two different groups. So example is toluidine, where one hydrogen is replaced by NH2 group and another hydrogen is replaced by CH3 group. So here this is ortho position, ortho to the aniline group, so it is ortho toluidine. When this group is here, then it is the meta position, so it is meta toluidine. And when this CH3 is here at para position, so it is known as para toluidine. Here same example is there, xylene, where two CH2 groups are there. When they are ortho to one another, they are ortho xylene. When they are meta to one another, it is meta xylene. And when they are para to one another, it is para xylene. The next type of benzene is trisubstituted benzene, where three hydrogen atoms are replaced by three different groups. Okay, so trimethyl benzene is the example. Here three methyl groups are present, first, second and third position. Begin from this 1 2 3, so 1 2 3 trimethyl benzene. Now 1 2 3 4, but 1 2 4 trimethyl benzene. Now 1 2 3 4 5 6, so 1 3 5 trimethyl benzene. Another example is trinitrotoluene. Here we are having four different derivatives or four different isomers. Here two nitro groups are present, ortho to the toluene group, and one is, or the methyl group, and one is meta to the methyl group. So here the name 2 3 6 trinitrotoluene, and again 2 4 6 trinitrotoluene. Here 2 3 4 trinitrotoluene, sorry, 3 4 5 trinitrotoluene. Here 2 3 4 trinitrotoluene. So this is how the benzenes are, or the aromatic compounds are given, named according to the substitution on the benzene ring. In next lecture we are going to see the structure of the benzene. Thank you.